when you're learning how to paraphrase correctly, to work with another student, work at the tutoring center, have other people take a look at the original material and take a look at your own paraphrase. Sometimes outside eyes are better at spotting what might be too close wording. Another thing that can be done is to try to take the paraphrase material, summarize it, or expand upon it. This way you've got to think about it more. You have to bring more of yourself into it. And that's what good integration of sources is. See if you can connect it to the points that you're making in the paper. It can even be good just to scan for the number of words that are simply synonyms. Taking a sentence or a paragraph and just looking for words that you can swap out for another word that means the same thing is still plagiarism. You're still doing, basically you're giving the original piece of writing and you've kind of touched it up a little bit with a word here or there. So successful paraphrasing really means trying to put all of the ideas into your own words.
The biggest tips on how to avoid plagiarism, first and foremost, just give a parenthetical citation. Whatever form that you're using, whether it's APA, MLA, Chicago style, they're all going to ask for a citation format, and whatever documentation guide you're using is going to show you exactly how to do their particular citation. Some might still use endnotes or footnotes, but all of these are a form of citation. Let your reader know that thing that came a second ago isn't my idea, it's someone else's idea, and you've given them credit. One way to sort of help you to not accidentally plagiarize is to get in the habit of always introducing where your material comes from. If you get in the habit as you're writing to always say, you know, Sarah Vasquez, professor emeritus at UCLA, says blah, 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 insert quote here. Even if you accidentally forget your parenthetical citation, you're not necessarily going to be taken to task for plagiarizing. They're just going to think, oh, this person forgot their citation, because that process of introducing where your material came from sort of erases the plagiarism to a certain degree. You're letting your reader know, look, I didn't come up with this, Sarah Vasquez did, I just happened to forget my parenthetical citation. But if that introduction is absent and your citation is absent, that's when you fully accidentally plagiarized, and that's when you're more likely to get in more trouble.
Another way to avoid plagiarism is to make sure you understand how to paraphrase. When you take notes from a book, I recommend that students take those notes in their own words. Then when you look at your notes to write your paper, change those words again in your own words. And then as you revise your draft from one to the next, eventually leading to a final copy, you're going to be so far removed from the actual words that the original author used that it's going to be your own work. As long as you cite the knowledge and information properly, you're going to be okay.